Good morning, everyone. My name is Trish Toutloff, and I'm with CIBM Mortgage. So are you guys ready? Are you ready for our next Lending You a Hand video, which is going to be tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock? So that's Wednesday morning, April 15th. You can't forget because it's tax day, right? But since a lot of us are working from home, and probably our computers or cell phones are right there, all you have to do is go to register.trishtoutloffmortgage.com and you'll be able to tune in live. If you can't tune in live, no big deal. We will record it like usual and you can just let me know and I'd be happy to send you a video, okay? Once we get that all recorded and put together. But our next, the next thing I'm going to talk about today, which is kind of going to give you another little idea of what we're going to be talking about, which is contract tips 101. What happens after both parties sign? Well, you need to keep your lender in the loop. You and your lender, as well as your real estate agents, shouldn't really be out of touch for the entire time that the transaction is going on. So even if you have a lot of stuff going on in your life, it's a really good idea to keep in contact with both parties because there's a lot of stuff, even though it seems kind of quiet at times, there's a lot of stuff going on in the background. So it's good to be touching base, if nothing else, on a weekly basis. As lenders, we also touch base after the contract is signed. We touch base with the real estate agents at least weekly. At least we should be. We definitely pride ourselves in communication. Peggy and I both are great at getting back to our real estate agents and our customers like you. So anyway, lenders like us, we have to abide by all the information stated by you. For example, if you say you want the seller to purchase a new roof because the current one is bad, we need to be sure that we have an invoice and a receipt indicating the work has been completed. So I know that's kind of frustrating, you know, that not only do you have to provide all the W-2s and all the tax information and now the tax transcripts and all this paper, now you have to provide us with more stuff after things are completed. And it's just part of the way the contract is written up when there's when there are items in the contract that need to be repaired or replaced and you guys have agreed upon that. You know, one of the things that we have to do before we go to closing, we have to make sure that legally everything that's written in that contract has happened, okay? So our loan documents must also match the contract. So be sure your contract has your full name with middle initial. If you're a junior or a senior, that's really important that you list that in there as well. Sometimes weird things show up on credit reports, and this way we can tell if it's a junior or a senior situation or a different middle initial. It really helps us to decipher all of that stuff. And make sure if you signed as a joint name couple, both are on the title. So, you know, if you sign jointly, both have to be on the title. Okay, does that make sense? And then also be sure not to choose weekends or holidays for a closing date. Can't close holidays and can't close on weekends. So anyway, I hope that helps. We're going to dig deep tomorrow morning. So you guys make sure you tune in, okay? Have a great day and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.